हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय स्वामी नारायण। थॉट ऑफ द डे, वेयर देयर इज अ विल देयर इज अ वे। इट मींस इफ वी हैव रियल पावर टू डू समथिंग दैट वी वांट, राइट, इफ वी वांट टू डू समथिंग एंड इफ वी हैव विल पावर टू डू दैट टास्क और टू कंप्लीट दैट वर्क, देन देयर इज ऑफ कोर्स अ वे टू डू दैट, टू कंप्लीट दैट। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, in this session of grammar we are going to start with the textbook solution. As in previous session we have already started the textbook solution and we have already started the chapter, that is noun, and we have already started, means I have already explained you about the types of noun, different types of nouns, right, that we have learned. So today we will start with textbook solution of noun. In this, question number 1 will be homework for you. Question number A, that is on page number 7, that is very easy. What you have to do in this, you have to fill in the flow chart with one example of for each kind of noun. Okay, for example, if it is abstract noun, you can write sadness, happiness, intelligence or whatever, right? For example, collective noun, a herd of sheep. For example, proper noun, common, right? For example, common noun, boy. In this way you have to give the example of each noun. Okay, so we'll start with question number B, page number 7. Now students, in question number B, what you are supposed to do? Now first one, filling the blanks with correct words. They have given the definition. From that, you have to identify which type of noun it is. We have already learned the types of noun, right? That is very easy. We have learned that, right? So first one, nouns are those that refer to something that can be counted. The nouns that we can count are countable nouns. So first one is countable. Second, dash noun denotes things that cannot be counted. Things that you cannot count will be uncountable. Now, third one, nouns that denote a male are of dash gender. Male means masculine gender. M for M, masculine for male. Okay, then nouns that denote a female are of dash gender. If we talk about female, then feminine. F for F, that is feminine for female. Now, next. A noun is a word that refers to a people, place or things in general. When we talk about people, place or things in general, for example, country. I have not mentioned that which country. For example, city. I have not mentioned that which city. There are many cities, there are many countries, but I have not mentioned the name, particular name. So when we are talking about in general, right, then that is common noun. Just for example, boy, right, for example, boys. Now there can be many boys, but I have not given a particular name of any boy. I am saying just in general, boys. So that will be common noun, students, okay. Now next, a noun that refers to quality and action or a state. Quality, action, states, feeling, ideas, this all comes in abstract noun. So sixth one is abstract noun. Now next, a noun that denotes just one person, place, animal or thing, only one. When we are talking about one person, place, animal or thing, for example this chalk, one chalk, right? So this will come in what? Singular noun. Now next, a noun is a name of particular person, place, animal or thing. Name of particular person. Particular person. For example, my name is Komal Shah. I am a teacher. Right? If we talk about teacher, then teachers can be many teachers. Right? So that is in general. That is common noun. But if I give a particular name of my Komal teacher, Komal ma'am. Right? Then that Komal is what? Proper noun. Right? So here it will be proper noun. What you have to write? You have to write proper noun. A noun that denotes more than one person, place, animal or a thing. If we talk about more than one person, animal, place or a thing. For example, right now I am holding two books of grammar. How many books? Two books. More than one? It is more than one. So it is which noun? Plural noun. If I am talking about one book, singular. But if I am talking about more than one book, plural noun. Right? So here what you will write? Plural. Now next. Now, noun that denotes things that are neither male nor female are of dash gender. Neither male nor female. It can be male also, it can be female also, right? So that is, they are known as neuter gender. What, students? Neuter gender, okay? They are of which gender? Neuter gender. Now next. A noun that refers a group of person, animals or things spoken as one whole. Okay, group of what? Group of a noun that refers a group of person, place or thing. Group of person. For example, constellation of stars, herd of sheep, pack of hunters, right? Gang of thieves, troop of dancers. So for particular noun we have, for particular group we have given the collective noun, right? So that is what? That is collective noun. In this way we have completed question number B. Now we will start with question number C. In this, what we have to do, we have already learned this this in lower classes, but then too I will explain it you explain to it to you again. Okay, underline the subject, circle the direct object, strike out the indirect object. Now first you need to know that what is subject, what is direct object and what is indirect object. It's very simple, but you have to listen to me carefully. I am explaining it here, okay, on this side. Okay, now first, when we talk about subject, when we talk about subject, subject is a person who has done the action. Subject is a person by whom the action is done. For example, I am writing on blackboard. So the action is done by whom? I. Right? So I will be the subject. She is cooking. She is what? She is cooking. So action is done by whom? She. She is cooking. Right? So that is what? Subject. Okay. Now if we talk about direct object. Right? If we talk about direct object, when direct object is given in the example. It has verb plus what. Now verb plus what means, just for example, Raman gave Nida a pen. Raman gave Nida a pen. Right? Now here, who has done the action in this sentence? Raman has done the action. So this will be subject. Now verb is there, that is gave. Gave is verb. Right? But what Raman gave, what he gave? He gave a pen. So your pen will be direct object. Right? Got it? What he gave, what? When it comes to what, then it is direct object. It means Raman gave Nida a pen. Raman is a subject because action is done by Raman. But what he gave to Nida? Pen. Okay. And now indirect object. Indirect object is always a receiver. Right? A person who receives something. Right? Jisko kuch milta hai. Receive. Right? So here in this sentence, who is a receiver? Nida. Nida got the pen. Right? So this will be indirect object. Okay, students? It means subject means a person who has done the object. Direct object is verb plus what. What that person got. Okay? And indirect object means a receiver. Okay, students? So we will start without wasting time. We will start. First one was this only. Raman gave Nida a pen. So that we have completed. Now we will start with second one. She bought her sister a skateboard. I am writing question here. She bought her sister a skateboard. Now, she bought. Who has done the action? Action is done by whom? She. So, she will be what? Subject. Now, what he bought? What is a verb? Verb plus what? What she bought? She bought skateboard. So, skateboard will be direct object. Now, for whom she bought, who is the receiver? Sister. Her sister is the receiver, right? So here receiver, sister will be indirect object. Okay, students? Like this you have to solve this. Now next is third one. They went on holidays last week. They went on holiday last week. Now in this sentence, students, subject is there. Who has done the action? They have done the action. Subject. But there is no indirect object and there is no direct object in this sentence, right? There is no indirect object or there is no direct object in this sentence. So, we will not do anything. Only they will, means we have to circle they as a subject. Now, fourth one. Deepu made a paper frog in class. Listen carefully. Deepu made. It means action is done by whom? Deepu. So, Deepu will be what? Deepu will be subject. Okay, students. Now, made a paper frog in class. Now, where he made a paper boat? Where he made? In class, right? So, class will be what? Direct object. Now, what about who is the receiver? A paper frog, right? What? Here, class. will be indirect object as class got a frog. Right? Now what Deepu made? Deepu made a paper frog. What? Right? Paper frog. So here paper frog will be direct object. Okay students, Deepu is a subject. He made, what he made? Paper frog. So paper frog will be direct object. And who is the receiver? Who got the paper? Now students, before starting next exercise, we are going to start a new topic, that is noun case. This might be new for you. We have learned this in 7th standard. But now you might be blank. Yes or no? Yes. Okay. So noun case. There are 3 types of noun case. How many types? 3 types. Nominative. Then objective. And possessive. Possessive is very easy. Okay. So first we'll talk about nominative, objective and possessive. First we'll talk about nominative. Now students, I will write one question for you in this. I will write one example for you. Carry, read a book. Okay. Now what is nominative case? Students, nominative case means when a noun or a pronoun is used as a subject in a sentence. Now as I told you in previous question that what is subject? Subject is an action done by a person. Right? So in this sentence, who has done the action? Curry has done the action. Right? So curry will come in which case? Curry will come in nominative case. Okay students, very simple. Curry will come in which case? Curry will come in nominative case as the action is done by Curry, as Curry is a subject in the sentence. Simple. Now if we talk about objective case, I will write a sentence here. Curry read a book. Same sentence. But here we are talking about objective case. Which case students? We are talking about objective case. Now, as we have learned about direct object, verb plus what, right? So, objective, it means we are talking about direct object, right? When we talk about direct object in the sentence, in this sentence, Curry read book, right? Curry is a subject. What she is reading? Book. So book will be direct object, right? So that direct object comes in which case? Objective case. Okay students, direct object we have already learned. So very simple. And possessive case is very, very simple. It shows the possession, right? If we want to learn it in an easy way, we can say that it always has apostrophe S in the sentence. Then that case will be possessive case. For example, Geeta's book. Now it shows the possession that this book is of Geeta. Can you see in this noun that it has apostrophe S? Then that is possessive case. Very simple. One more. The girl's bag. It shows the possession that the bag is of girl, right? And it has apostrophe. So this comes in which noun? Which case? Possessive case. Okay students, so we have learned about 3 cases, that is nominative case, objective case and possessive case. Exercise related to this we will do in next session. Till that, keep learning, stay home, stay safe, bye bye and take care of yourself.